In this simulation, we're looking at two beakers, both of which contain 10 grams of ice and 100 grams of water. And what we're going to do is drop metal blocks into each beaker. And on the left side, the red beaker, we show the temperature, the heat capacity of the block, the mass of the block, the area of the block, and the number of blocks being dropped. And then on the right side, we can pick different values for the same parameters. And then what we're going to plot is how much ice melts as a function of time and the temperature of the blocks as a function of time. So when we hit the start button, we'll see these plots form. We can change how long the plots go. So you notice we have 120 seconds here, and that corresponds to the x-axis. We can also change how fast it's displayed on the screen if we want to speed things up so it takes less time to see the behavior. Now, this simulation makes some assumptions. One, we have perfect mixing, so the temperature throughout the beaker is uniform, and as long as ice is present, it's at 0 degrees C, and the temperature within the block is uniform. In other words, the heat transfer, the thermal conductivity of block is high compared to the heat transfer between the block and the water. And the end result is that we're going to assume the block temperature changes throughout at the same rate. Now, if we add enough blocks, or blocks with high enough heat capacity, then what we're going to see is that all the ice will melt and now the water will actually warm up below 0 degrees C. Now, the rate of heat transfer can be increased between the block and the water by adding a stir bar, clicking the box here for a stir bar. And so essentially we're changing heat transfer coefficient between the water and the block. Now, the simulation has more detailed directions and details of the equations by clicking the appropriate orange rectangle areas. But let's look at the actual simulation and what happens when we click this start button. So here's the interactive simulation. We can, for example, change the mass of blocks, also the area of the blocks, and the number. And let's make the blocks on the right much warmer, have significant heat capacity. And you notice we have the option of plotting temperature versus time, amount of ice melting, or showing both plots on smaller scales. And so let's hit the start button and observe now for the two blocks, the red beaker, the one on the left, is number one. And so notice the difference in the rate that the ice is melting and the temperature of the blocks. So in beaker two, where we started with much colder blocks, they are approaching 0 degrees faster. And in the simulation time, we can't see what happens. So let's reset and let's speed it up so it doesn't take as long, but we'll look at it for a longer time. And let's start again. Now what we've done is just speed up how we're displaying. You notice beaker 2 gets to 0 degrees by 150 seconds and beaker 1 is not there yet. And remember, we have 10 grams of ice. So if we were to, let's reset once more. If we were to make this temperature high, and let's just change, let's compare. So let me pause and make a different comparison. So what I've done is set the same conditions for both sides. And the only difference now is I'm going to add the stir bar to the right. And I don't want it to go too fast. And let's look at the simulation now. And notice the effect of the stir bar is that we much more quickly melt the ice. We much more quickly get to 0 degrees C, we've increased the heat transfer coefficient. And if we let it run long enough, we start seeing, at least for the beaker, the blue beaker with the stirring, we reach the final conditions, reach equilibrium. So we'll reset once more. Now I've made the temperature high on the right side and a high heat capacity and adding four blocks and hitting start and watching the behavior. So notice now for the beaker on the right side, we reach a point where we've melted all of the ice. And that happens after a relatively short time because of the high heat capacity and the high temperature. And now notice for the blue beaker on the right side, we're not approaching 0°C. As the blocks cool down to the temperature of the water, it looks like we're at about 11 or 12 degrees C. And so you can hit directions to get more information about the simulation, and you can look at the equations in details. But the idea is to get a better understanding of rates of heat transfer and how they depend on properties, in this case of the blocks and on stirring.